Oh, hello. I didn't see you there. Welcome to Regulation Corner. Take a seat. Get comfortable. Maybe pour yourself a drink. Lovely stuff. You know, I've just been sitting here with my industrial plug and connector from Scame, and it's got me thinking about a regulation that you may not have considered before, but it's got something quite appealing about it. I'll share it with you if I may. It's in part 5 of the regs, which deals with the selection and indeed the erection of equipment. And turning to chapter 55, which deals with other equipment, we find subheading 553.2, cable couplers. And in regulation 553.2.1, we read the following. Except for a CELV or a class 2 circuit, a cable coupler shall comply where appropriate with BS 6991, BSEN 61535, BSEN 60309-2, or BSEN 60320-1, shall be non-reversible and shall have provision for the connection of a protective conductor. And as a bonus, let's consider regulation 553.2.2. A cable coupler shall be arranged so that the connector of the coupler is fitted at the end of the cable remote from the supply. Again, the deeper we dive into the regs, the more layers we find to peel back and a greater sense of depth can be felt, like the authors are teasing us with a sense of some bigger insight into electrical matters, but just always keeping it at the very tips of our fingers, not quite within our grasp, leading to an ever deeper striving for understanding. Some may say that this is simply common sense and that if we need to be told to put a coupler on the end of the lead, that means that we won't have exposed plug pins at the other end, then maybe we shouldn't be electricians. However, to you naysayers, I ask you this. What does it take for common sense to become common sense? Think about it. But what do I know? I'm just a bloke sitting in a chair reading the regs. I won't keep you any longer. Thanks for stopping by. And the next time you're passing, drop in, say hello. You know there's always a place for you here at Regulation Corner. Good night.